Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone had a wonderful Thanksgiving holiday. Today is Saturday, November 27th, 2021. Last night at 11:35 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 4.1 earthquake along the Cascadia subduction zone. It was 6.9 kilometers in depth, which would be 4.2 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. Four people said they felt this earthquake. I'm sure more did, but didn't send in a report to USGS Did You Feel It webpage. And then at about 3 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 3.5 also in the same area. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that 4.1. Here's the location of that 3.5. Back in 1922, there was a magnitude 7.3. And let's bring it out so you can see how close it is to the area of the Cascadia subduction zone. Here we have Eureka, we got Crescent City, we got Brookings. This area has been developing pressure for about the last 300 years for a major earthquake. A big earthquake along this fault could affect the cities of Seattle, Tacoma, Portland, Eugene, Salem, and Olympia. Groundworks did a study about the worst areas to live for the potential for a large earthquake could be displaced. The ground could drop 6 feet and would move maybe 30 to 100 feet to the west within a matter of seconds. The mountains that have built up in the last 300 years would drop, they would flatten, and release the current geo-compression, all that pressure that's built up. FEMA predicts that a Cascadia earthquake and tsunami would injure 27,000 people, kill 13,000 people, and damage a million homes. The odds for a next large earthquake are about 33%. However, even a small quake has the potential to cause property damage and disruption. Yeah, injuries, power outages, small tsunamis, etc. They also have a map here showing the areas of the greatest risk. You can see the coast of the U.S. there. The New Madrid fault zone. Yeah, there was an earthquake there also. And then the Alaska Peninsula. And let's not forget Hawaii. Yeah, the Big Island. On the felt map for the 4.1, you can see here we got reports from Eureka and what is that? McKinneyville, it looks like. Many of the younger generation is not prepared for a large earthquake. You need to have a plan for evacuation for a tsunami. Here we have marked out the earthquakes that have occurred within the last 7 days and the hazard map. Let's bring this up. Scientists had believed that the Cascadia fault zone had pretty much healed up. There hadn't been any major earthquakes in quite a while. It's got a lot of pressure built up. A lot. If there is a large earthquake along this area, it would not just be one wave. It would probably produce several waves coming in one after another. Evacuation would be difficult because of all the debris in the roads, the power lines, bridges out, etc. Are you prepared? Do you have a plan? Is your home or apartment earthquakes prepared, safe? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.